Welcome again to Rutiger and to the cross-country venue which has served us so well during the 2019 Winter Universiad. It's proved a very successful hunting ground for the hosts, the Russian Federation winning six of the seven finals contested so far. Conditions a little different today, and I'm sure you can see on your screens a bit of snow is with us. And we're here for more relays today, a mixture of classic and freestyle racing. Fans well rugged up and perhaps anticipating another Russian presence on the podium. It's hard to see it not happening, especially in the first event. The ladies 3x5K. So the first skier will ski in the classic style and the second and third in freestyle. And each athlete does 5 kilometres. So 15 in all for the women. A little bit of a different proposition perhaps for the wax technicians today, with some overnight snow changing things up a little bit as they apply the heat and the special secret chemicals that we're not allowed to know about. Well, I don't think they tell each other anyway, the rival teams. They've all got this special secret mix. It's minus four. The snow temperature's been a steady minus six most days. And there's the humidity, a little bit of wind from the southwest. And we have some light snow. It's been coming and going through the night and morning. We're coming up to 10 o'clock local time in Krasnoyarsk in central Siberia.
Okay.
So a little bit of checking of equipment. We've got 13 teams in, including the team from Canada and the USA. Not really expected to feature today. The Russian combination of Kapochenko, Smirnova and Zambalova look mighty tough to beat. Expecting perhaps a challenge from Italy there, and they'll be in bib number nine, and maybe Japan, Kazakhstan. And away they go. And this is the 3x5K cross-country relay, with a mixture of classic first up and then freestyle for the second and third legs. And it looks like Kapochenko will be looking to lead them out of the stadium. She's 23 years of age. Her teammates are 22 and 24. So they've got quite a few kilometres of training and competition in the legs. They've got good endurance, good speed, and good teamwork. So we have Russia in one, Kazakhstan two, Belarus three, China in bib number four, Canada five. And already the early pace is enough to sort out teams not quite so strong in cross-country skiing at the Universiad level. It will be Kapochenko who comes through. Finland's Emmy Lamsa has moved up to take over second place behind Russia. Certainly got too well off the back in the USA and Republic of Korea, but it's Russia, Finland, Italy, Kazakhstan, Slovenia, Japan, Belarus and Austria, and there's only 7 seconds between those top eight. Now, back to the leaders. And still, Lamsa is managing to hang on to Kapochenko. Kapochenko to hand over to Ekaterina Smirnova for Finland. It'll be Petra Torvinen. Pretty encouraging for Finland. They'll be looking for their second medal of the cross-country program today. Here we have our leaders. And Finland is settling back in behind Russia. So it's Kapochenko and Lamsa. And waiting to take over, Smirnova and Torvinen. Smirnova for the Russian Federation, next to go. And the fans pretty excited about the position. And now Kapochenko makes a bit of an effort. And will hand over first by about 5 metres. Just a little touch on the back or the shoulder is all that's required in the changeover area, and that's successfully done by the first two. So away they go. Ekaterina Smirnova, silver medalist in the 5K Classic and 5K Pursuit on days one and two here at Radoga. Petra Torvinen, can she hang on? Up front though, and here perhaps is the move. Smirnova using this climb to try and get rid of Petra Torvinen, who looks to be struggling with the steepness of that one. I like the rhythm here of Yokohama. She's moving along quite nicely. Good control, good pace. Nice rhythm, steady on the skis, no slipping. Oh, that's nice to see the chat between Kirpichenko and Martina Bellini of the Russian Federation in Italy. Here to compete and to make new friends, and big smiles there. And that's exactly what the Universiade wants to see out of this competition. Do your best, and perhaps along the way, make some new friends and compete in the spirit that is so important to maintain, uphold, and even improve. So the Russian Federation first into the stadium, and that's the excitement reflected in the crowd. A limit of one team per country in this 3x5K race for the women and men. So the Russian Federation, even though they've got a big squad, a maximum of eight they can bring to the games and choose six for any event. There's a limit of one team per country here in this relay. Now, Smirnova's lead. She is really building. She has taken it out hard. Second and third skiers using the freestyle technique. Great second leg being skied by Shiori Yokohama. She comes in now and she'll find herself 42 seconds behind Smirnova. And Torvinen of Finland just about to be caught by Franchi. So Italy will move shortly into third position, but I don't think that Franchi is really taking any ground out of Yokohama. On screen now, and the young Japanese competitor is doing a super job. So Smirnova approaching now the changeover area to send Elisa Zambalova on her way. Let's see if she makes the right contact. Of course she does. They didn't need to take any risks there, and they didn't. They're just in the middle of the changeover area and skating into the arena now comes Francesca Franchi. She's skied a mighty second leg for Italy to move them from fourth to second. But well behind the Russian Federation. She's opened up a gap of about 50 metres now over Japan's Yokohama. Yokohama to hand over to Kadami for Italy. Franchi to send Di Francesco away. Oh, and that touch between the Italians only just happened in the legal area. I think the Japanese will be willing to take quite that risk. They don't. Oh, oh, had to have two goes at it. I think it's all right. You think it's a straightforward thing to do, but when the finishing athlete is fatiguing, as Yokohama surely was, then it would be easy to understand how he could muck that up. And she hands over to Mika Kodama. So as you see, Zambalova out front under no threat from these two with only 2.5 Ks to go. And she's still got that winning rhythm about her skiing. As we check out Dzhambalova once more, and this will be her third gold medal. She's got two individual golds, and now here in the 3x5K relay. So they've opted to put Dzhambalova last. And she won gold in both the freestyle 5K and the, sorry, here's the freestyle 5K pursuit and the 5K classic on the first day. She's very good at both. I don't think the Russian coaches would have had too much trouble deciding who to put in this team. They had the gold, silver and bronze medalists from the first 2 days in both races, classic and freestyle, so spoilt for choice. And here we have Japan and Italy. Still hard at it, Kodami and DiFrancesco. And Kodami up this rise, just starting to open up a bit of a gap. This is promising for Japan. She's found out DiFrancesco, perhaps. DiFrancesco's skis, we know, are running very well on the downhill sections, but she's got to find the stamina to stick with Kodami, who is trying to open up a deciding gap here and looks to be doing it. As they too, the both of them, ski past the United States, who are on a different lap. They're coming up also behind the Republic of Korea. So here are the hard yards, really, for DiFrancesco. She's got to keep pace somehow with Kodama. And DiFrancesco, the shoulders are dropping a little. Still a nice rhythm and energy about Mika Kodama's work up the hill. And this gap is getting bigger and bigger, and a big concern to the Italian team if they want this silver medal. DiFrancesco, she's running out of gas. It's just going to be a question of by how far for the Russian Federation. Dzhambalova out on her own. This is just like a Saturday afternoon ski, except it's Saturday morning. Coming up to 20 minutes to 11 in Krasnoyarsk. Conditions very kind now. The breeze hardly ruffling the flags around the arena. Clouds have cleared away. Dzhambalova enjoying this little bit of coasting around the course. Alisa Dzhambalova. There's no hurry about this. Just skating along nicely, comfortably, and way, way out in front. Yana Kirpichenko led it off for the Russian Federation. She changed over first, just ahead of Finland, to Ekaterina Smirnova, who opened up a big gap over the rest of the field. And by the time Smirnova sent Dzhambalova out on the last leg, well, you know what was going to happen. And it's happening now, as Dzhambalova, in front of an adoring grandstand full of Russian Federation fans, comes to the line to be met by her teammates. It's gold to the Russian Federation in the women's 3x5K. Well, they've done what was expected, but sometimes the burden of expectation can bring you unstuck. Not so for these women today. There's the Japanese team waiting. Takizawa and Yokohama. And Mika Kodama has seen off DiFrancesco and moved comfortably away from her. So are going to be a first medal for Japan in the cross country. Kazui Takazawa, Shiori Yokohama, and now Mika Kodama. Italy issued the challenge. They're going to have to settle for third, and they look quite pleased about that nonetheless, and they should be, as Ilenia Di Francesco comes into the stadium. But well behind this woman, Mika Kodama, who's in the home straight now. Italian and Japanese and Russian competitors, all great sportsmanship. Silver medal for Japan behind the Russian Federation, who've already congratulated them. And now the Italian team, Martina Bellini and Francesca Franchi, eager to greet Ilenia Di Francesco, who comes across in third position for Italy. A minute 56 behind the Russian Federation. Well, you can't help but be delighted to see the joy and the pleasure that they're taking out of the race, the results, their effort. They've done their best. The cards then just fall where they may. But if you pick up a place and a medal, well, how good is that? So the Russian Federation claiming the women's 3x5K relay from Japan and Italy. Great race it was for second and third. And Kazakhstan, Belarus, Finland, Norway and Austria. So over a minute between third and fourth. A minute 24 between seventh and eighth. So the field was really strung out at various points. Slovenia finishing ninth. Then it was Canada, the United States, Republic of Korea, and China. We'll be right back. Another fine race completed at Krasnoyarsk. That there confirms the result for the women's 3x5K. Russia, Japan, and Italy.
Awarding ceremony for cross-country skiing, women's relay.